I always try and really safeguard and hold sacred that first moment when I read a play, because as a director, you'll never have that. You'll never have that again. It's virgin territory, and the audience that then come in night after night, that's the experience that they're going to have, is the first time. So you have to kind of hold it as a template to always refer back to, because you're never going to be unadulterated again. You're never going to be a virgin again with that particular play. So it's kind of amazing. I remember going to Glasgow University in 1990, and it was the City of Culture. And I remember being taken by one of my, I was doing sciences, medicine at the time. And I remember being taken by one of my friends to the Tramway Theatre to see a production by a Quebecois director, they said. And I was like, where's Quebecois? They went, it's Canada, Johnny. I was like, okay. And it was Robert Lepage, and it was his show Tectonic Plates. And I remember the moment that the story went from a library in Venice, where they were in a pool, a shallow pool, and there were books stacked behind them, the characters, and they were going to New York. And all that happened is that Robert turned a light on behind the books, and they created the silhouette of the Manhattan skyline reflected in the Hudson River. And that was it. It was like suddenly being born and going, oh, well, that's what I want to do then. So I changed from the course I was doing to doing theatre and classics within about 2 months. The process of directing for me changes dramatically, actually, depending on what the project is. And I love that about it. I don't have a rigid process into which a project must fit, but I like projects that scare me. And are going to make me question the way that I think I know how to work, or that what's worked before, or what I think might work again. It has to start with an emotional connection. So when you read a play, or when a project is proposed to you, it has to be connected to here. Because otherwise, I wouldn't know how to try and make that then connect with the audience emotionally. I don't perform anymore, mercifully, for audiences all over. But I have experienced that, and I sit in audiences, both seeing other people's work and developing work that I'm making. And there is something that happens when you get it right, when the kind of the energy, the air between the audience and the stage, the audience and the actors, suddenly just something just crystallizes in the most beautiful way, and you suddenly feel that everything is in sync, and you can almost feel the little gasp as people kind of are so amazed to be connected to each other. From the very beginning, from Homer right through to Tennessee Williams, it's, you know, we come to the theatre because we want to observe and experience together what it means to be a human being. I remember a real moment of awakening for me was the playwright and director Anthony Nielsen talking about boredom in theatre and audiences being bored. And it was a real zing moment for me when he was talking about the fact that people sometimes talk about going to the theatre as if they're going to church, that in some way the very act of going to the theatre is good for you, that it's good for the soul, and you know, sometimes at parties, and you know, We all get this. People say, what do you do? And you say, I work in theatre. And they say, oh, I should go to the theatre more. And that should tells you everything you need to know about what we can do wrong sometimes. Because people don't say, I should watch Strictly Come Dancing more, or I should play my Xbox more. You know, but you know, we have to make theatre that demands audiences running through those doors. Not that they should feel that they ought to come in through those doors, but that they have to just come in.